Following protracted negotiations and a stream of surrenders by individual German armies in northwest Europe, Italy, the Netherlands, southern Germany and Denmark, the new leader of Germany since Hitler's death on the 30th of April 1945, Grand Admiral Karl Dönitz, caved in to Western demands and ordered a general surrender. At 02:41 hours on the morning of the 7th of May 1945, the Chief of Staff of the German Armed Forces High Command, Colonel General Alfred Jodl, signed the unconditional surrender document of all German armed forces at General Eisenhower's headquarters at Reims, France. According to the agreement, the Germans would cease all active operations at 23:01 hours the next night, 8th of May 1945. Incredibly, many German units fighting the Soviets continued with active resistance on the 8th of May and even for a few days afterwards. The Luftwaffe had continued air operations at best it could under skies totally dominated by the Allied air forces. Despite critical shortages of aviation fuel, ammunition and spare parts, most of Germany's remaining 3,000-plus aircraft were grounded, but a few units still managed to get some fighters airborne on the war's last day, 8th of May 1945. Even more incredibly, three German pilots scored aerial victories on the last day of fighting, even as they headed for Allied captivity. Oberleutnant Gerhard Thieben was the first to shoot down an enemy aircraft on VE Day. Piloting a Focke-Wulf 190 of Jagdgeschwader 54, he took off early in the morning and headed over the Baltic Sea. Ships were still evacuating the Kurland pocket, where thousands of German troops and civilians were trapped by the Soviet advance against the Baltic Sea. Thieben was a highly decorated ace, having been awarded the Knight's Cross with oak leaves, with well over 100 aerial victories to his name. At 07:54 hours, he spotted a Red Air Force Peteljakov PE-2 bomber that was probably searching for German evacuation ships. Thieben closed rapidly and shot it down into the sea, killing the three crew, then flew on to British-occupied territory, landed, and promptly surrendered. Soon after, Major or Major Erich Hartmann, Germany's highest-scoring fighter ace, took off in a Messerschmitt Bf 109 K4 from Brod in eastern Bohemia, setting course towards Brno. With an astounding 351 kills to his name, and the rare award of the Knight's Cross with oak leaves, swords and diamonds, Hartmann was about to secure his 352nd confirmed kill of the war. Flying with his wingman at 12,000 feet, Hartmann spotted 8 Soviet Yak-9 fighters. He could see that the Soviet pilots were inexperienced and he pounced, successfully shooting down one Yak-9 over the burning city below. He would have attacked more, but for the appearance of 12 American P-51 Mustangs overhead. Diving into the smoke below, Hartmann and his wingman made good their escape and landed back at base. He was told that the war was over and ordered to fly to Dortmund in the British sector to avoid capture by the Soviets, but he refused to leave his squadron, with the Soviets only 25 miles or 40 kilometers away. Hartmann ordered all 25 serviceable Messerschmitt 109s to be destroyed, and then everybody marched west, surrendering to the US 90th Infantry Division a few days later. The last Luftwaffe aerial victory of the war belonged to a pilot flying one of Germany's most advanced aircraft. Oberleutnant Fritz Steller of Jagdgeschwader 7 took off at 15:10 hours from his base at Zartec in Czechoslovakia, 65 kilometers northwest of Prague. Jagdgeschwader 7 was the world's first operational jet fighter squadron, flying the revolutionary Messerschmitt ME-262. The squadron's aircraft had been intercepting US and British bombers since March 1945. During the afternoon of the 8th of May, with their airfield threatened by the Red Army, all airworthy ME-262s were ordered to fly to parts of Germany occupied by the Western Allies and surrender. A large number of damaged or unserviceable aircraft were left behind at Zartec. Oberleutnant Steller and his wingmen intercepted a flight of Soviet fighters over the city of Freiburg in Saxony. Stähler quickly got onto the tail of a P-39 Era Cobra and blasted it out of the sky. He then flew on and landed at a British-occupied base at Fassberg, having scored the last German aerial victory of the war. His Messerschmitt 262 was later shipped to Canada for evaluation to RCAF station Aylmer near London, Ontario. In 1950, it was scrapped, save its two engines, which are currently on display at the Canadian Aviation Museum. So ended the final flights of the Luftwaffe in World War II. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share and help support my channel, PayPal and Patreon. Details in the description box below.